Welcome to this GDevelop5 game development stream, and today we are going to see how we can add touch controls to our game so that we can run our game on mobile platforms. So we were designing our server, but this question was more important because we wanted to know how can we add touch controls in our game. So let's see how we can do that. So we will first be doing that, adding touch controls, and later after this we will be working on our server. So I am thinking about one more thing, and that is that I will be making a new repository for the game, and that new repository will contain the game, this game only, but it will contain a version which will not have any networking capabilities. It will just be a standalone game and there will be no networking elements in it. Right now in our current game we will be making networking elements for our game, but there will be a version of the game which will not have any networking elements at all, because maybe some of you just want to make a standalone game without the networking capabilities, and so we will see how to do that. It's easier actually. So I will be making two repositories, one which will have a game which will not have any networking capabilities, and one which we were working on, that is a game which will have leaderboards and networking capabilities. So I'm going to just make a new repository on GitHub so that there is no confusion between the game which has networking capabilities and the game which does not have networking capabilities. So let me open the project, but it got closed apparently. Oh yeah, I forgot how to open the project because I didn't work on GDevelop for 5 days, 4 to 5 days I guess. Yeah, right now you can see that we have this leaderboard button in our game and this account button in our game, but maybe some of you don't want to add networking capabilities to your game, so your game will not have this leaderboard button and this account button, right? But both of them will have touch capabilities. I will make the separate repository for the standalone game with no networking capabilities. But right now let us add some touch controls. So right now if you look at your buttons, start where we want touch right now in this screen, on this button, on all these buttons we want touch controls. And you can see one thing, and that is that the touchable area is too big, right? So we need to fix that first. Let me fix that. I will go to double click on start button, edit with Pascal. Height is 6, width is 12, no, width is 32 still, and resize that. Yep, good. And now maintain aspect ratio and do it 512 and save, apply, bring it down here. So as you can see, we removed the extra parts, but our button got a little less defined. But that is okay. We have to adjust with that. You can actually go into PayScale and design it a little better, but I will just keep it this way to save time. And the same thing we have to do with this button, leaderboard button. Let's do it. Double click on leaderboard. I think I can just replace the image with the image which I just created for the start button. Let's see if I can find it somewhere. I think this is the one. Because the size is exactly the same for the start button also. You can choose the same thing. It won't make a difference because we are not going to be editing this image, right? Because if we edit it, then it will change everywhere, right? It will also change in the start button, it will also change in this button, but we are not going to be editing it, so we can just use the same for all three buttons. Just to open it, and for this one I have to remove it. So can I remove it anywhere? Yeah, no, I have to go inside PayScale to remove it. Why is it like this? Not looking good. So I guess I will just do it again. I'm just doing this to reduce the clickable area in my buttons. Because if it will be too big, then the player will touch somewhere else, but the button will get touched, right? Now we are done, and now let us start to assign touch events to these. Right now we have this kind of event, mouse X and mouse Y is inside start button, or mouse X and mouse Y is inside exit button, right? We don't have leaderboard button yet, but instead of mouse X and mouse Y being inside this button, we have to do something else. So just double click on it, and from common condition for all objects, you go to mouse and touch, and click on this. The cursor slash touch is on the object on the start button. Accurate test, yes, accurate test. And so now it will work for touch, but we have this left mouse button was released. While touching, there will be no mouse. So how will mouse button be released in the case of touch? So in this case, we have to add another condition which will say that touch was released. A touch was released. So go to mouse and touch and multi-touch. A touch has ended. Yeah. A touch has return true if a touch has ended. The touch identifier can be accessed using that. once for each test. Okay, attach has ended. We will see, we will have to test it somehow, and I think we will have to convert it into APK to test it. But let's first type it, just write it, write this and this everywhere on all the buttons. Let me just copy, shift select and copy, and in the other button just delete this one and paste condition. Okay, yeah. So and let me make one for leaderboard also, but like I was saying, first let me make a new repository for the game which will not have any networking capabilities. So I will type Soul Hunter Downtown standalone means it does not depend on any external server or network or anything to give its full value, right? You can get all the value and content from the game without a server or some other application or some network. So standalone, the game itself is all the experience that the player will get from the game itself. This is the repository for the standalone, standalone version of Soul Hunter Downtown, a version of the game which does not depend on networking and does not have a leaderboard or sign up system or account system. Leaderboard. So that's it. The entire experience which the game is supposed to give will be given by the game itself, and we will not need to rely on anything else, any network or something public. I will initialize it with a readme and then create. We will be doing the networking thing, but first let me publish the standalone version, because maybe some of you don't want to go into networking, because networking can be a little bit difficult if you are new to it. So that's why let's first publish the game without any networking capabilities. So I have copied the link, Control A and Control C, copy. And now I will go into my game dev folder, right click, Git Bash. You must install Git in order to use Git, right? And I will just type Git clone, and I will right click and paste the URL, and I will type the folder name also. You are free to not type that, but I will, Soul Hunter Downtown standalone. So it did that. So I have Soul Hunter Downtown standalone, and I have my repo. So what I will do is I will go to my repo folder, which is my original Soul Hunter Downtown folder in which we were working. I will just Control A everything and Control C everything, and then put it into the Soul Hunter Downtown standalone. And so I have everything here, right? Now I will just push everything to the repository. Again, Git Bash here, get status, it will show me lots of things. Git add dot git commit minus m initial commit, git push origin master. It will take some time. Let me pause the video and I will resume when it has done. So now it has done uploading my changes to my repository. Let me go and check. So yeah, I have everything in my repository, and it's kind of a long list because I have not put my graphics in a different folder. I should have done, but anyway, I think I will do it sometime later. So now you can see that I will delete the very old version because I don't need it. So shift delete and delete, and it's gone. Okay, no problem. Now you can see that I have two versions of my game. One is this one and one is that one, right? And this one will be the game which will not have networking capabilities, right? And this one will be the game which will have networking capabilities. Right now I'm going to work on the standalone version and publish it, export it, and show you how to do all that. And after doing that, after completing it, I will come back to the version with networking capabilities, right? Because networking can be a little bit, you know, difficult to understand when you are new to it. So this is the version with networking capabilities. I will be now closing it and I will be opening my standalone version. Standalone, I will open the game.json here. game.json, it's the same so far, the same thing which was in the other version, right? And now let's do it and go to main menu. I will remove the leaderboard button because we don't need it. I will remove the account button. We only need these two because this is the standalone version of the game. Yeah, and we have done this touch thing, and we have to do the same in this upgrade button also. And just copy this our touch has ended statement and just paste it here. That's good. So in this screen we have taken care of our touch capabilities, and because we have some space here, I think we can put our score here. That means points and coins. So it will be good practice to put it over here. So let me do that. I will now add a new object, right? I will call it coin sprite. And I will add animation. I will call the default, and I will add from my folder some coins. This one should do nicely. Apply, and then again I will add a sprite, and I will call it point sprite, and I will add an animation, and I will call it default, and I will add, and I will search for points. But this is too big. 32 cross 32. No. It was I think it was this. It should be small. Okay, whatever. Just choose one. I will just choose this one. Light. I will bring this here. I will bring this here. I will just scale it down, whatever. Or scale this up. Right, and now some text, point text, size can be 40, color should be white, it should be bold, and by default 0. And just duplicate this and type point text, and you can double click on it, and it's good, it's looking good. Just drag it here and just drag this here. Maybe you can put it a little bit over here. You can see, I think that because you can see that these handles are towards the right side, your right. So when you increase that value of the points and coins, this will fill up like this. This will fill up towards here, and this also, because the handles are this way, so it should fill up towards that direction. That's why I put them very close to the icons. Now the thing which we have to do is show the actual value. We will show the global variable. And we will do this only at the start of the scene, and we don't need to do it every frame. So add an action, add a new empty event. Where was it added? There. So I will now add condition, and that will be at the start, beginning of the scene, and just bind the variable to the text object, modify the text object is point text first. Is equal to variables text of a global variable, and that is points. Okay, so and just copy this and paste it and double click on it, and instead of point text just choose point text, instead of coins just write points, right? So that's okay. So it's good. And here this condition is, this action is not, does not have anything, so let me just delete this. Okay, so now it will show me my coins and points, and it will work for touch, hopefully. Let me just run it. So big. It's not working. Oh yeah, I forgot to do that. Yeah. First thing, why was it so big? And let me see why it was so big. Let me go to start button is actually pretty big. And I should edit it, right? Or I will just delete. Okay. Yeah, actions are gone, and I will just take my exit button and duplicate it and write start button. There you go, I have a perfect start button again. But I have to edit it Z order, which should be, you know, something which is less than the start button, the start text. I will just type all of them and see which one is less. Maybe one is less. Yeah, 10. So 10 works. That may not be the most efficient way to do that, but can do that. Yeah, so we have a good looking start button, and yeah, it was not working because we have put both of these conditions, and it should be, you know, it will check whether mouse button was released and the touch was released. So we have, what we have to do is delete this line from both of them. Yeah, from all of them actually. And the cursor is touch is on, cursor or touch is on upgrade screen, and we have to add the cursor slash touch is on our button, which is start button. It got deleted because we deleted the button, but I don't know why the exit button got deleted, but let's add it anyway. Exit. Yeah, so now it should work for just the mouse, but we want it to work for touch also. First let us check whether it is working for mouse or not. It is working. Okay, that's cool. Now for touch, just we will add three new events, right? So just add three new events, and just I think I will put them together somewhere. Yeah. Now just copy these two lines, shift select, and then right click copy, and in all these three just paste this, and remove this line, left mouse button was released, delete this, remove this, left mouse button was released, delete this, and remove this, delete this, right? And now just add a condition that will be touch was released, touch has ended. A touch has ended. Okay, cool. And copy this and paste it on these three. And instead of exit button, we need the start button here. And one should be exit, and this one should be upgrade screen button. Okay, so this should work. And for each one of them, we have to paste their actions also. Just copy the action for the upgrade screen and put it in the upgrade screen section. And for start button, just copy the action for the start button and put it next to start button. And for this one, we don't have anything here, but we have something here. So I believe if I can just copy this, I can copy it. Just copy that. I clicked on it. You can click here also and right click and copy, and to paste it on this exit, first click here to select this action and then add a sub event. So now you have added a sub event, and in the sub event you just click here on the sub event and right click and paste, and now you have exactly this event here also, right? So that's good. And for the quit one, just select the quit one by clicking here or here, right click and copy, and then come to this one and then click here and right click and paste, and now you have also pasted the quit event here. And now we don't need this event which does not do anything, so just select it and delete it. We have effectively just copied these two and pasted them here. Now it should work for both mouse and touch, but let us test it. It's working for mouse, but I have to test whether it's working for touch as well. For that you will have to publish the game, but first let us do that in our actual game also. But before actual game, we have to do it in the stage selector and in the stage one unlock message, right? And in the pause screen and in the upgrade screen. So that's a lot of thing which we have to do before we can even get to these two. So let's do it, because we have to do it anyway, because we want to export this to Android. Just go to this, and there is a lot of, we are not going to be doing here, doing anything in these two, but here we have to do something, right? And there is a lot of thing here, and it's kind of okay. First thing we should do is remove all these wherever there is mouse X and mouse Y. Remove all these here also maybe, and in place of this we have to add the touch, whether the touch is in touch or cursor is inside the object. So yeah, just add a new condition. Mouse and touch, cursor slash touch is on an object, and I think stage one button is there. Yeah, and after adding this, just delete this, and wherever else you have seen this stage one button, just copy this one and paste it there. Copy, and in another stage one button, mouse X and mouse Y command, delete that and just paste it. And in this one, all this one is reversed. You can see that it is reversed. So we have to do the same thing. Delete it, paste it, double click on it, and invert the condition. And nowhere else we can find the mouse X and mouse Y thing. And now we have it for stage two. So for stage two, again, you can, I stage two button, that is. You can just add this, and instead of stage 1 button, you can type here stage 2 button, and just copy this and click here and delete this. And in stage 2 button, mouse X and mouse Y command, just paste this and delete this. And here also, just paste it and delete this and invert it. Right? So now it should work. No, right now we have done this. Okay, mouse is on cursor slash touch is here, and maybe here also you can do the same thing. Add condition for the cursor slash touch for the left arrow, I guess. No, it is for right arrow. So just type right arrow, right, delete this one. And here add for the left arrow, and delete this one. Cool, that's okay. And now in these, we have to copy these two events and paste them and change this left mouse button was released command to a touch has ended. So let me see if I can shift select two events. I think I am able to do that. Shift select two events and copy them, and then right click here only and paste. So I was able to copy these two and paste them here. I mean, this has been pasted here, and this has been pasted right below it. So I want to just, you know, bring them together, bring both of them together. Stage 1, stage 2, stage 1, stage 2. That's it. And instead of left mouse button was released, we have to do it this touch, or touch has ended. And here also a touch has ended. Like this, it will work on both PC and mobile phones. That's why we are keeping both left mouse button and touch, right? I have these exact statements here also. Why is that? I should delete them. And this one also, because these are the same statement as this one. I think it got copied many times, more times than it was necessary. This and this. Yeah, that's all. That should work. And for back button and experience, what is this exp button? I also don't know what's ESP button, EXP button. It may be something, I don't know. So, in our button behavior also, we have done that. I think we have done the other thing. Let me see. Functions and behaviors, button extension, button. Oh, shit. Yeah. Button and button function. Yeah, we have done this mouse X and mouse Y, mouse X and mouse Y, and this and this. And we are not using button press function. In back button also we have done mouse X and mouse Y. Right, we should have done the cursor slash touch is on object. Let us do that. Here we will do that and reverse the condition. Reverse it. And just delete this, and here just copy this one and paste it and unreverse it, and just delete this and paste it and unreverse it. And after this, for this event has to be written again, but this time for the touch has ended command. So just click on this event and copy this event and just click here, maybe in the empty event, and just paste. So it got pasted exactly once. So let me now change this to a touch has ended. A touch has ended. So we have done for both mouse and touch. So now those buttons should work. Delete this statement, we don't need that. So yeah, that's done, and we don't use pressed function, but we do use this one. I think you can just copy this one and then paste it and reverse it. And here also just paste it. And here also just paste it and then delete these. Right. And here you can see that left mouse button is down. Okay, it says touch or left mouse button is down. Does it say that everywhere? No. Only here you can see that touch or left mouse button is down. So, oh yeah, there is a command for mouse button release and this one also. So that's good. Touch or left mouse button, this command is also there, so you can, I guess, replace this one, the simple mouse command with the other one, and then you don't have to copy these two and paste them here and then write another condition for this. So that's a really good thing. We will use that from now. I didn't know this existed before, so that's okay. So this command alone will take care of, you know, both mouse and touch. So why do we need this? Just delete this, right? And then delete this one also. So this should give me a good result for touch or left mouse button is down. Here can I have you don't have a function which does that, I mean, which checks for both which checks for the release of both mouse or touch. So I guess you have to do it that way, in the way we, in which we were doing. So that's okay, we have done that. We'd only have a function which checks for a mouse button pressed or touch held, but we don't have a function which checks for mouse button released or touch released. So for touch we have to write it again anyway. For holding the touch down or holding the mouse button down, you have one function which checks for both, but for releasing we don't have one function that checks for both. So we have to copy and paste. Here we don't have to do that. Here it's one function which is checking for both, but for releasing there is no one function that checks for both. So just to select this event and maybe just copy it and paste it. Yeah, and instead of left mouse button was released, we can just say touch has ended, right? So that's good. Now all our buttons which are associated with this behavior should work in touch, in a touch interface as well as in a mouse interface. So let's close this. So this will work. We have done the same thing, but we have to do the touch released also. Okay, touch release. Yeah, okay, just copy this. Did I cut it? Oh no, undo. Just copy this and paste it right here, and just copy the left one and paste it right here itself, and bring them together. And instead of left mouse button was released, select touch has ended. Touch has ended, right? So now this should work for both mouse and touch. Should work, hopefully. And this will work because we have done the changes in our button behavior. This should work. Now let's go to the pause, the stage one unlock message, this and this. So it's not a lot of things, so let me just add the condition for that. Mouse and touch inside what was that, unlock message? No, not unlock message. I think it was play next stage. Yeah, delete this, we don't need that. And here also keep playing, add the touch checking for keep playing. Yes, okay. And delete this one. And we need to copy this and this and paste them for working with, so that they can work with touch. Copy and paste. So it got copied and pasted here, right? The same thing, whole thing. And instead of left mouse button was released, just check touch has ended, right? So now it will work for touch also. And here or this one also, just copy this one, copy and paste. Instead of left mouse button, just use a touch as ended. So now this should, we have one mouse version and one touch version. Mouse version, touch version, right? This is also done. Now let's go to pause screen and let's go here. And again, for continue text, add this for continue text, and then delete that one. And for main menu text also, add this main menu text, and then delete that one and save, and then copy this and paste it, and change the left mouse button to a touch has ended, right? And this one also, just copy this and paste it. Instead of left mouse button, just choose a touch has ended. So we have a mouse version and a touch version for continue text and a mouse version and a touch version for main menu text. The pause screen is also done and hopefully it works. For upgrade screen. Now upgrade screen has a lot of buttons, not a lot of buttons, 3 buttons, 1, 2 and 3. And these buttons are associated with the behavior. So we don't have to, I don't believe we have to program them too much. Here you know, we have to do it 3 times. And here the mouse version is there where we will check mouse button release, here also and here also. But we just have to do this, copy this one event, copy it and click, right click here only and paste it. And now I have 2 health upgrade sections, right? I will not close this one because it's kind of don't need that. And here only do this, instead of left mouse button was released, I will just let show it. Instead of left mouse button was released, you just select a touch arrow. So now our head button will work for mouse. Damage upgrade, copy and right click here only and paste. Now I have 2 versions. In the second version, just go and select a touch as ended. Now our damage button will work for both mouse and touch. And for attack speed upgrade, just copy it and right click here only and paste it. And now I have 2 versions for attack speed upgrade. And the second version, just go here and select multi-touch, a touch as ended, okay. Now all 3 of our upgrade buttons should work for both mouse and touch, right? Let me close the upgrade screen. Now we have done all the screens. Now we only have to look after the stage 1 and stage 2. First of all, stage 1, which is the button that needs to be taken care of? Pause button. First of all, pause button. Where is, yeah, there, here at the very end. Okay, let me, here at the very end we have made the pause functionality. So instead of mouse X and mouse Y, just to choose this cursor slash touch is on object and on pause button object. Delete this one and just copy this code, copy and then right click here only and paste. So now instead of left mouse button was released, you select touch as ended. So that's good. It will now work for both mouse and touch, hopefully. And same thing we have to do in the second stage also, because we are not using same event, same layout for it. Again, just do the same thing. And wait. Pause button, okay, and then mouse X and mouse Y should be removed, and then just copy this, copy and paste. Instead of left mouse button was released, you choose a touch as ended. So the touch has ended. So we have done this for both the stages. Cool, pretty cool, work. So hopefully it works, hopefully. And let me open main menu and test a little bit at this point. So it's working. It's working with mouse. We will check with the touch also soon. So now, in order to jump, I'm using my keyboard to jump and attack, right? But we should use some touch interface to jump and attack. So I will be adding two buttons over here which will enable me to jump and attack. Let me add them. Now I will add two very simple buttons. Just go here and add a new object sprite. Type jump button, add animation, just type default. We will not be animating it, maybe. No, let's just edit with Pascal. But it was important for editing. Just make a circle and maybe you want the gray color a little bit. I guess I will just choose gray color and draw a circle. Not visible. Now I will draw an arrow. This looks good. And for attack button, make a sprite. I think these two buttons are looking good, and let us put them for little bit far apart, because in touch interface your thumbs should not overlap with two buttons, right? Because there is a chance that. So now let us add some property to them. We have to do the same for stage 2 also. So I will not making the buttons again. I will just be adding them. So let me do that. put them approximately where you would want them to be, not exactly the same, but approximately. A little bit here. Yeah, okay, that's good. Now let's add the code. Where have we used that one? I can see this one, delete that because we don't need it. Delete, and it must be here also, so just select it and delete. We don't need that. And now here left mouse button was released, so it is simulating a jump key press. That is okay. We have to do that when the player touches, that is a button, right? Okay, and here also we have some checking going on. We will do that also. And here also we have some checking going on. Right mouse button was released. This is for right mouse. Left mouse and right mouse, and right mouse. Right mouse is just attacking and left mouse is jumping. So that's what it is. Here also right mouse was checked. And nowhere else have we, and nowhere, oh here also, oh that is for pause button, that's okay. So in these places, this statement and this statement, in four statements, in four events, we have used the button release function. So I think we have to one by one copy these events, paste them and make them for the touch interface also. Just copy and just paste it. Instead of left mouse button was released, we have to check whether we pressed on the jump button. Right? Yeah. And let's do that. Our jump button, and we also released the touch, such as enter. Delete this. So this will do the same thing, make the girl jump. And now this one is kind of complicated. Before doing this, I will like to do these two. And just copy this and paste. And instead of right mouse button was released, we have to check for touch. And right mouse button means in our case that it was for firing, so attack button. Touch or cursor is on attack button, and touch was released. Where is it? Touch has ended. Then delete this mouse button was released. Okay, we have duplicated one into this one, and now this also has to be duplicated. Yeah. Copy this and paste it here only, and then just add right mouse button means we are attacking, so we will add a touch checking for attack button, and then touch released, right, and then delete this one, right. This has been duplicated into this, and this has been duplicated into this, right? So, and now we are left with only one event that we have not yet managed. That is this one. Let me first copy that. Copy and paste. First, let us understand what this event is doing. If the ninja girl is on floor and I have not touched on my attack button and I have not touched on my jump button and the animation of ninja girl is not throw, then the animation of ninja girl will be set to idle. That's what this statement shows. So I think all we have to do here is to check whether a touch has ended or not, right? I mean, do we really have to check whether we are touching on the button or not? I mean, touch has not ended and my cursor slash touch is not on my buttons. I think that's all we need to check. I believe, maybe. Let's first delete the mouse checking because we're not doing that here. Add the condition whether your touch was inside the jump button or not. Whether it was not inverted. And the same thing for the attack button. Invert. Now it is almost looking similar to that one. Yeah. Because this should be here. Yeah. Almost similar to that one. So it will check. Our touch should not be on top of jump button or attack button and it should not have ended. Then, and the animation of the ninja girl is throw, not throw, and she is on floor. Then the animation will be set to idle. Let's see if it works or not. So we have done this. I still have to put these statements in the stage 2. Let's do that. I will just copy one by one, not at once. So this one is the first one. Just copy this and come here and just right click on this one and paste so that it gets pasted. Yeah, cool. And then again for the big one, just copy this and come here and paste it below the big one. It pasted above, I will paste below. And for the right mouse button one here, just right click and copy and here come back here in the right mouse button was release thing, just paste. It got pasted above, I will paste it below. Here one more is left. Right mouse button was released. Copy this one and then go here and then just paste and bring it down here. We have one for this and one for this and one for this and one for this. That's okay, that's good. Let's check if it is working or not. Oh yeah, we can't check that as long as we are using the mouse, right? So I guess I will have to export the game to Android or maybe run it on my device through USB debugging. Let me see if I can do that. There is an option for that. Now export the game. Let us try to do that. I have opened my scene, which will be the first scene of the game, according to me, which it will be the data loader scene, right? Let us click here, export the game. Android. Build a game locally as a part of a project. Okay. Let's do this. Okay. It is uploading. I will pause the video and I will wait for it to upload. So it has uploaded and it is now processing the build. I mean building the game. So let's wait for it. It says 5 minutes. So I think I will pause the video and wait for 5 minutes and then resume it when it has done. So it has finished the build and now it says you can download it on the Android phone and install it. So I will download. I just clicked on the download button and it has started the download in my browser. So what I will do is I will transfer that on my Android phone. So it is 7 megabytes. It has done downloading and I will just plug my phone in my computer. Or maybe wait, I will just transfer it to my drive maybe. And I will just transfer the file to my Google Drive and then from there I will transfer it to my phone and then install it on the phone, right? So let me do that. I will pause the video and do that because that's something, it's not very difficult, right? So I will do that now. So I have now downloaded the game on my phone, the APK of the game. So I will put the feed of the game here. So this is the game, Soul Hunter Downtown. I will now open it. And as you can see that it is kind of working, but again it's very fiddly as you can see, and it's starting from stage 2 rather than from our loader screen, and it was kind of fiddly because it was registering the touch as well as the mouse. On my phone it was registering the touch as well as the mouse. So although everything is, I mean the buttons are working, but in our game it is performing the functionality for the buttons also, as well as it is registering touches everywhere. It is registering touches everywhere and it is registering them on the buttons. So that may be a problem, and it's not starting from the stage from which we want it to start. It's starting from the stage 2, so we will have to fix these issues. And so that's that. It's working, we can open this, we can upgrade, but we don't have enough coins, right? that's that. It's so in the phone you can see, I will put the feed also, but you can see here that I can run it on my phone pretty well, no problem in doing that. I hope you also don't face any problem, but right now our game is kind of fiddly, and in the next video we will be fixing all that problems, and so that we can ship a high quality Android game. And so if you are enjoying this stream, you can join me tomorrow as well. Thank you for watching.